Hey, this is Dejs and Tay. Welcome to our channel. I'm Tay.
And I'm Dejs.
And today, today DMX passed. So we're going to be doing top 50 DMX songs, the greatest hits.
And we, you know.
We know who he is.
Yeah, you just say that. We love him and his music and
his acting.
Yes.
Been here for a long time.
Yeah, he's been in the industry for a long time. And, you know, ups and downs, it happens. And we know, you know, quite a few songs from him. Not a lot, or, you know.
But we know quite a few.
Yeah.
But I don't think we know all of them. So
because he had hits, they were on the radio, they were on movies, you know. So.
What's your first DMX song?
Am
I putting you on the spot? Mine's is Angel. That's like Angel one of my favorite songs from DMX is Angel. And I think her name, the woman who sang it was Angela something. I think so. I don't know.
Yeah, I like that. And Who We Be.
Oh, yeah. Who We Be. That's the doo-doo. Okay, let's start. We're going to get into it to see how, you know, recipes.
It was he was definitely
an influence,
yeah, an icon, you know, because of what he did for the music industry. It was different sound.
He'll definitely have a legacy. Yeah, his sound was totally different.
And I don't know if he was part of the Rough Riders, and we got to see other rappers, you know, that came in the game.
Who will be truly missed. So we're just gonna get into this. We're not gonna do too much.
Oh my mother. Dang. It's Rasputin?
Yeah. Never heard this song.
That's what I'm saying. Even though 2015 was a long time ago, 2012 was a long time ago, I didn't even know he was making new music still. That's what I'm saying about a lot of artists that's been in the game for a long time, but old artists, you know, like DMX or Ice Cube, how they were still making music, but not popular for. It's not out there.
It's not getting noticed.
Yeah.
I didn't know, too.
Especially, you know, even though this had to do with DMX, like Ice Cube, he had a whole album, and he made that Good Cop, Bad song. Good Cop, Bad Cop, and it represents what's going on in the world today and what was going on back in the days. And it's like, wow, this is a good song, this is a good video. Why is it not out there? Same thing with DMX, his redemption, you know?
Yeah, I don't...
His life.
I don't think people care about those type of songs, and I mean the real hardcore fans obviously, but if your music is not like how it was or it has this new sound, then I don't think nobody's gonna pay really good
and
close attention to it.
That's why a lot of old artists, I don't want to say old, you know, but artists that's been here for a long time or made music in the 90s or early 2000s and they make music now, but they're trying to sound like the new generation music, and I don't like that because it's not their sound. Even though it's good to have your own new sound, but make sure it's you and not trying to fit in so you can have a hit. You know, okay.
So. We're gonna get to 49, Last Hope. Feel like I let my people down. Yeah. This was in 2012.
I'm looking at the list. That would sound like him.
I never heard this song either.
What's it?
2012, of course. We didn't know that.
And that's kind of our past, too. Sorry, I don't want to talk too much. And that's kind of our fault.
Sorry.
He made so many songs. And that's, look at albums. And that's kind of our fault, too. You know, I'm not going to say I'm a huge fan of DMX or a lot of, you know, people.
Well, 2012, we was listening to, like, pop music.
That's
you know?
True, but I'm just saying, like, if you say you're a fan of a certain celebrity, DMX or Ice Cube or Lil' Kim or something, and they're still making music now, you know, I'm not gonna say it's your job, but if you say you're a fan, listen to the music, you know. Mm-hmm. I don't know, because I didn't even know. We didn't know.
I gotta get, hear more of this song. Cause that was, wow. This sound familiar. The beat.
It kind of sounds like Evil though, but that one song.
Yeah. Like, he has so much energy. Like, yeah. You can't it's not like, say nothing without him having energy. Excellent. That was a good movie. I gotta get this song. I like it. I like that. This definitely sounds like the 2000s.
Yeah. Early 2000s. Okay.
Like, this could be when we got saved.
You know what I'm saying?
I like this. Rest in peace to Aaliyah too. Are y'all gonna say it? Don't fall in love with you. True.
That sounds familiar too.
That sounds familiar. Is that really his dog, though?
I don't know. I remember seeing this. I used to be so scared. What the hell? That showed my face, but I remember.
Never heard this song.
I thought he looked like a devil before when I saw that.
Little Freddy Krueger thing. This Freddy Krueger thing. I like that, though. I gotta get that song too. You can learn a lot from him, what he's saying. Cause he be speaking some real stuff.
Yeah, you know, he went through some stuff. You know, he's talking about life. Yeah.
He's not just talking about money and females, he's talking about some real stuff. This sounds familiar, the beat.
And his flow goes really fast.
His flow fits perfect with the beat.
That's the one song.
Here comes the hot stuff.
Mm-hmm. I like
his,
that.
His voice goes perfect with his beat too.
Yeah, it does.
The flow. Like, his voice is so unique.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you just don't really hear no rapper sound like that. Well, Ja Rule, but.
Yeah,
this sounds
I
different.
So, like, if you're being like a scare movie, like a hood scare movie.
I heard this song before. When he made a bad move, it was my place to stall. I never told him nothing wrong. Kept it fair. That do I do.
That's it.
It sound like it. My slips, my falls, my trials and tribulations. My heart, my walls, my mother, my father. I love him. That's, yeah. We definitely have not heard a lot of these songs. Oh my gosh.
I know we're gonna start because a lot of these songs sound really good.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'm gonna get some of these songs.
And it's actually cool about these videos, you get to learn more songs and have it in your playlist.
I had like how they rap and like the piano went with it.
Yeah, I kind of thought that would be in better a little bit.
I like this one. It's all about the park. If the dog off, baby, it's about the spark. The heat is on. What's my next move? Do I stick with the score or get with the door? Feds got the drop in the back of the U-Haul. Snipers on the roof, chance of getting away, too small. Tell them like this, look, it's gonna be a shootout. Whoever make it out, meet me back at the... Whoever did this, did great with this.
I really like this cover.
The belly?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's so different.
It is.
I don't even like that could be their body, just their heads.
And you know, everybody try to do the same. That's like envious jealousy right there. This don't sound like it just be the 90s, it sounds like it'd be in 2002.
It's 90?
Yeah, it's just 1997. I like this one. It's a nice aunt, yeah.
I don't know if they made a song for him.
I didn't know either. This is nice. Sticky Fingers, and what's the other one named?
Fredo Star.
Fredo Star?
I don't know the other one.
The Great Depression, like that's like a really beautiful album. I like this song. I like his voice and this, the singing. He's singing on this song, it's dope.
That's the thing about when he raps, you can tell he had, you know, the pain.
Yeah, and emotion.
That's not the same emotion.
Like, he definitely has passion when he, rapping or singing.
Especially when he used to perform live, too.
Girl to the Grave, that was a good movie, too. He said, I'm going to play in these movies, but I'm going to have my music on here, too.
Yeah, a lot, too.
He did. I wonder what happened to Chili. Who are we singing this one?
This is 14?
Uh-huh.
I thought it would be higher.
You thought it would be higher?
Mm-hmm.
What do you guys think about this list? Do you think this should be number 14? I like the beat, but I don't know if this should be 13, though. This definitely sound like it'll be in 2000s.
And not about just how it sounds, about the lyrics too, boo-boo.
I definitely heard this song before.
So, three different ones of this song?
I like about his songs that he has, That's sad, you know, that you get all this money, you know, and you're still alone, you know, you can't trust nobody. I'm gonna stop right here for a second. You know, he's talking about, you know, he was robbing and then he was rapping it, and it seems like either way, I mean, he won, like he became successful, but at the same time, he still wasn't really, he was happy, you know, he got family, he has kids, but at the same time, I don't know if he was really happy with himself, mm-hmm. sort of, because obviously he said he felt alone, you know. And that
you can have times when you're happy and you have times when you're unhappy, mm-hmm. you know. I don't think he was unhappy all the time,
mm-hmm.
but clearly, you know, he had things to help cope mm-hmm. or something. Because when you're in the streets and you need to survive,
mm-hmm.
you know, I don't know, you know.
No, I get it. Just sad, you know. I feel like you can't win either or, though, you know. Be robbing and I don't know.
You could tell music was really a part of his life because he never stopped making music. And all that he cared about hits, you know, even though that's really, you know, that's what people are looking for. That's what people want, especially celebrities, because that's going to make you more money and give rewards and stuff like that. But I don't know if he really cared about that, you know. All he cared about was probably making music, and it's out there for you to feel it, so you could hear it, you know. He could hear it and he could feel it too.
Yeah,
that's his pain. That was, like you said, his emotions.
Mm-hmm.
So why not put it in a song?
Yeah, it's like his music was, you know, you could just hear the passion in it, and it seemed like it's very therapeutic for him, and this was his outlet, his escape, mm-hmm. was to do music. I just think people, you know, messed him over a lot, and that made him do, you know, certain things. You know, people messed him up, you know.
Yeah, and it's,
people took advantage of him, to me.
Yeah, and like you said, you know, it could have happened in the music industry, but he had things going on before his life too,
mm-hmm.
and you don't really forget certain things.
Mm-hmm.
So you have things going on in your life, plus the industry, mixing it both, you know. And then he definitely had some good music videos, you know, that matched well with certain songs that was going on with his life.
Mm-hmm.
And then all his songs wasn't sad or just about life. It was about having fun, too, you know.
Yeah, it was definitely about having fun, too. And he's a great storyteller.
Mm-hmm.
He's a great storyteller.
Yeah, this song definitely deserves to be on the top 10.
This one, yeah.
Mm.
Well, Who Would Be should be up here too. Why is it like all the way in the...
Okay. Everyone is different, this is really amazing.
This definitely sounds like this could be a Swiss Beats on this one.
Yeah, but don't it kind of feel like Evil Liquor too?
Yeah, like but you know Swiss Beats was with writers.
Stay on the floor.
like that. It's like second person or third person. He does that a lot with his music.
Oh, this is my favorite rapper guy.
I don't want it. Did they have to play that part though?
I don't know. How are you gonna show?
I feel like this would be up there.
It is like my first song with her from home, of course.
Yeah, our first song with her from when we was babies.
Mm-hmm. And it was on our, like, my.
I see this being up there, but. Mm-hmm. Oh, this one too. I forgot this was on a movie.
Yeah. It was when it was the fighting scene, right? Or when it was on the. I don't know. Yeah, this definitely deserves to be on top 10. This is that beat too. And every star give it to you. Yeah, give it to you. I'm sorry.
Yeah, they should play that part. Mm.
Oh, wow. I forgot about this.
Of course, it's gonna be number one.
Yeah.
They should play that part though. His flow of this though.
Yeah, I like how his flow is different from our song. What's your favorite song? I forgot where the hood is at. I haven't heard that one for a long time. Where the hood?
Okay,
but
so.
But it's an angel. That would be cool.
Yeah, that would be great if they had that on the list. Angel. I feel like that was a very emotional song to me. And Angel is, you know, basically he talk about too. Yeah, it was from Cradle to the Grave, and that song, you know, he was talking about his faith
and the talking back.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Kind of like saying
she was like a, I don't know, she kind of was like an angel, but
yeah,
like he's by your side, you know, you just gotta do right.
Yeah, and then he, you know, he talks to himself, kind of.
Mm-hmm.
Kind of.
Just it didn't seem like he was talking to God a little bit.
That's what I was saying. I didn't really want to say it, but yeah. That's what I was talking about. Kind of same thing with Snoop Dogg song, Murder Was the Case.
Mm-hmm.
The whole going back and forth.
Mm-hmm.
And like you talk to someone else, especially about your life.
And now it's heaven. Something like that.
I don't really say that.
I know, but I don't know. It's just, I don't know, something about those type of music. I don't know.
And it was another song on there too. And it sounded like, you know, the whole.
That's why the back and forth.
Yeah.
I don't know what to call that. I don't want to say it's like a second or third person, but I like when he goes back and forth like that in mm-hmm. his music. I feel like some of the list wasn't accurate to me, some of them.
Because we haven't heard a lot of these songs. Like we said, we're not like.
But some of the songs that we did get to hear for a little bit, I feel like it could have been like, oh yeah, this one should have been up there. Yeah.
Gonna add some of that to our playlist.
Yeah, definitely. Let us know what you guys think about this
list,
top 50 rank, songs, and what would be your top five or top ten?
What's your one favorite song from him?
Yeah, what's your one favorite song from him? Again, mine's just Angel.
Angel, or and Where's the Hood At? I really forgot about this. I used to rap that song all the time. No, but it's gonna be messing with it. You like me? Anything to the M to the X.
Okay, so yeah, what do you guys think about the top 50 songs, and how do you feel about him, you know, being gone?
Back in One Piece to when we used to play that.
That's our favorite song.
Yeah,
even though not Leah.
Yeah, even though not his song, but
this is
he made the song. Yeah,
yeah, he made that's his song.
Cause he has like
it was equal.
Well, he had like two verses.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
it was equal.
Yeah.
Yeah. So this, I don't know. I feel different now. Not, you know. Him being here now, you know, let us know how you think about our reaction, like, comment, subscribe, and let us know what to probably react to next from DMX or any other artists or any rap artists.
And then, you know, just say something positive about him.
Yeah, just say something positive about him.
No negativity, and it's just like we said, he made the music industry because his sound was different.
Mm-hmm.
because he was spitting some real stuff
mm-hmm.
about his life, about somebody else's life, you know, what it was growing up. Yeah.
And he definitely is going to leave a mark, you mm-hmm. know. If these new artists didn't know him, now they know him. Because, it sucks.
You know, they was getting their style from him, too. Mm-hmm. You know? So, all you gotta do is just respect it. Because you know? I heard a couple of songs, like, oh, this sound like DMX, you know? They was doing the whole growling and the voice as him.
He was the first one, but I could definitely tell you that. Because I didn't hear nobody sound like him.
No, that's what I'm saying. He was different.
He was different.
Very New York, too.
Yeah, very New York. So, yeah, let us know what you think about this whole thing. I don't know what to say next, you know.
Just rest peace to him, mm-hmm. you know.
Prayers goes out to his and family. His children.
What, his mom? He said his mom passed. So he's with her, right?
I think so.
He's with her.
His grandmother.
Oh, his grandmother. Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah, because he says something about drama with his mom on the song. Mm-hmm. So, I'm not really going to speak on that, but, you know, he's with loved ones, and he's with other rappers that helped make music, mm-hmm. you know, help bring new style, help change, because a lot of rappers back then was actually doing stuff for the community.
Not just rappers, but, you know, like, leaders.
Leaders, period.
Because to see everyone.
Using their voices to help change.
Yeah.
And DMX was doing a lot of things, too. Mm-hmm. It wasn't just rapping. Or definitely, making movies.
Most definitely. Yeah, so, like, comment, subscribe. Thank you, and be safe. And
have a blessed day. Mm-hmm. Thank you.